Now let me talk about the next topic, final keyword. So this also be very interesting. We are following the same book, the complete reference, Java complete reference, and other resources also we are going to follow. The final keyword in Java, it is going to talking about the final in the sense means what? Normally it is a fixed. There is no change at all. It is a final. Final in the sense it is a fixed of that one. There is no at all. Once it is going to be declared in variable or a method or a class, if you declare as a final, then there is no way to modify, to alter that type of things, right? So let me discuss in detail about the final keyword. Now here, final keyword in Java is used to restrict the user. Restrict the user means what? Restrict the program. Okay. So final keyword in Java is used to restrict the user. So now restriction of the user is nothing but restriction of the program. So in many contexts, the final keyword can be used. What are that different context is? We can apply for a variable, we can apply for a method, we can apply for a class. In these three contexts, we can apply this final keyword. So let me discuss with an example how we can apply for a variable, how we can apply for a method, how we can apply for a class. So let me discuss the first one, how we can apply for a final variable. Now I'm just creating a class called as bike9 or any other class. I'm just initializing a variable called as speed limit of integer type as a final keyword, final variable. And I'm initializing as 90 value. This is final. For the speed limit, we are fixing, it's a 90, it's a final. Now I'm just running a method, implementing a method, that is defining a method run, and speed limit I'm going to changing from 90 to 400. Now I'm calling the main method and I'm just creating an object for the bike9 class. And with the help of object, I'm calling this method run. Now, when you are trying to change the final variable, which is speed limit from 90 to 400 in the run method, it will be raise the error. That error is called as compile time error. Okay. So let me see an example how this will be done. So I have already have programmed the final variable. So I'm just instead of bike9, I have replaced the class name as variable, final variable. And see, speed limit is 90. And in the run method, we are going to be changing from 90 to 400. I'm calling the main method and I'm creating an object here. And with the help of the object, I'm going to calling this run method and just run the program. So Java C space final variable, varvl dot Java. Okay, see the error. Can't assign a value to final variable speed limit. We can't assign a value to final variable because already it is a final. The speed limit is initialized to 90. We are not able to assign any other values for that speed limit variable. Okay, so please make sure that one. So that is one example of how we can apply a final keyword for a variable. Now coming to the second one, which is a method. How we can apply a final to a final keyword for a method. Now I'm creating a class called as bike here, bike or some other class. And I'm just defining a method as final. The name of the method is run. I'm just displaying as running. Now I'm extends with the help of the inheritance concept. I am creating one more class which extends bike, which extends this one. Inheritance means what? Acquiring the properties of parent by child. Now here child is Honda and parent is bike. It is extracting that all. Extends, and in this class Honda, I'm creating the same method run. And I'm changing run safely with 100 kilometers per hour, right? Now I'm just calling the main method and creating an object for this one. And with the help of the object, I'm calling the run method. So I'm creating the object for which class? Honda class. So when I'm calling Honda.run means, which method will be called? The method which is related to the Honda class, not the method for the bike. Now it is going to be called here, right? So this method, when it is trying to call the Honda method, Honda run method, now it is raise the compile time error because it is extends the bike. Extends the bike means, which is the already, there is a method called as final void run. So this method run and this method both are same names. What is called as method overloading? When method name is same, having with different arguments, two arguments, three arguments, four arguments, or different arguments or same arguments, different data types of that arguments. This is how we have seen in method overloading. We have one more concept called as method overriding. Method overriding, we have another concept called as method overriding. Method overriding means what? Means parent class is using same method, child class also using same method. When these two classes, parent or child or different classes are using the same method in the same program, same method are using by different classes. That class may be a parent class, one class may be a child class, using the same method. At that time, then it is called as method overwriting. So when you are acquiring the properties of the bike, that is a parent class, by the child Honda class, automatically you are acquiring the method run also, right? But this run has declared as final. So you are not able to access this method because that method has declared as with the help of final keyword. So we can't change the running to running safely with 100 kilometers per hour because this method has declared as final keyword. Now let me see, run the program. So I have a program over here, method, final method. I just rename the class name for our better understanding. Instead of bike 9, bike. So see here, final void run method is available. Now I'm extending Honda class with the properties of final method, and I'm just creating the method here, run method. I'm just calling the main method and creating an object for Honda class, Honda.run. When it is trying to run the Honda.run, it is trying this. Now what will happen? Let me see. Now run the program. Java C space final method dot Java. Now see the error. Now see here, run in Honda can't overwrite run in final method, because this run and this run, what is the difference? In the parent run method, it is declared as final because of declaring that as a final, and the Honda class is extending. The Honda class is extending the properties of bike. So that's why we can't overwrite the run method of Honda. We can't overwrite the run method, which is declared as final method. So there is an error here. Overwritten method is final. So there is a, because of that, it raised the error. Okay. So that's what the concept you're going to be explaining. Using the final keyword, prevent the method overwriting. We can't be overwrite the same things over here. So once you declare a method as a final, we can't be overwrite. The third one, applying the final keyword to a class. Now see, final class bike, for the bike class, we are declaring as final. Now I'm extending this Honda one is a parent, child, bike one is the parent, extending that one. I'm running the class run. So safely ran with 100 kilometers, calling the main method and creating an object, Honda.run. When you're trying to call the Honda.run, it will go to here. But once you are creating the object for this Honda class is extending what? Parent class. What is the parent class? Yes, bike. What type of class it is? Final class. So you can't inherit this final class over here. This is raise and compared error. Because it declared as final and you are trying to implementing a method called as run with the help of this child class object, which is extended by the parent class, which is extends from parent class. Because this parent class has declared as final, as a declare as a final, we can't extend this one. Because of not extending this, here we are going to be not call this run method. Okay. So if you make any variable as final, what will happen? You can't change that value to the final. It is called as constant. When you declare as a final for a variable, now automatically what it treated as is a constant, no change at all. 90 can't be changed to 400. If you make a method as final, you can't overwrite it. Method overwriting. Method overwriting means what? Parent class and child class both are using the same method name. If you make a class as a final, you can't extend it. You can't extend means what? You can't apply inheritance concept over here. Now let me run this program. So already I have a class called as final class here, final class here. And I'm just extending final class. I just replace with the help of bike. I just replace the class name, final class here, and run method and calling a main method, creating an object for this and calling this run. Now let me see what will happen for this program. Clear the screen, Java C space, final class dot Java. Now see the error. can't inherit from final class. Final class is the name of the class name. Final is a keyword. From final class, which is declared as a final class, we can't inherit. That's why it is arising error. Okay. So that is the concept over here. So in three ways, we can apply the final, a variable, a method, a class. For what purpose we can use final means? In some cases where you are not trying for some of the variables, some of the methods, some of the classes are there where we can't touch that one. It is a fixed. There is no change at all. Like for example, final in the sense, like your username for your gmail.com, for your gmail.com, username is final. There is no change. You can change your password. You can change your first name. You can change your profile. But the user name is fixed one. That is the cases we can apply the final variable. Coming to the method, once you are going to make it as a final method, for example, once you have changed anything, send a mail, you are not able to change that mail until unless it asks you for undo. If you ask there undo, if it is okay. If it is not apply for undo, if you once it is sent, we can't change that one because it is a fixed final. We can't change the date. We can't change anything over there. Similarly for classes also. In real time, we are going to be using for that. And there is a question of this one to slightly understood. Is final method inherited? What we have said, a final class can't be inherited. If method, when you are applying a method as a final, we can't overwrite. But when you apply a final method, we can be inherit. A methods can be inherited. But methods can't be overwrite when you declare that method as final. Try to understand. When you declare a method as final, we can't be overwrite. We can't be overwrite it. In this example, we can't overwrite it. But when you declare a method as if you want to be inherit that method, we can inherit a method. But a class can't be inherited, but a method can be inherited. How means? It can be inherited. How the possibilities of this one is? See the possibilities. Final method is inherited, but it can't override. How means? See the example. I am creating a class called as by. I am declaring a method as final. Clear? Now I am extends here. Now a class is extending. A parent class is extends a child class. Now in this, with the help of I'm calling a method and I'm creating an object for this. It is going to be have the anonymous object I'm going to creating. I'm calling the run method over here, but it will be call. There is no problem because it is extending this one. But what is the difference for this program and the previous program? Here in this line, we are not using any method called as run again. Here we are not using run. If you are using run here, it definitely raises the error because it is not method can't be, a final method can't be override. So see previously here, what is the difference for previous one, this one? This class is same, method is same, and this line is same, but here one extra line we are adding, here the extra line, void run. This is nothing but method overriding. We are removing this line, and calling the program. So how, see here, we are remove that line and directly we are call the main method and call the object. So at this case, it will run the program. A class can't be inherited using the final keyword, but using the final keyword, a method can be inherited because you are going to be inheriting the class, which is a final method, which is available in the parent class. And we are calling that method a normal method. How we are going to call it, that how we are calling the normal method, it will be calls that because it is acquiring the properties of the parent class by child class. So that's why it will be give the output as run. Let me run the program so that you can understand very clearly. So here all the program is there, final inheritance, already the program is available. Final inheritance. I just changed the name as here. Final inheritance. See, I'm creating a class called as Honda2 and run the method. Final void run method. Just running message. And I'm creating one more class called as final inheritance. Extends Honda2. And I'm calling the main method. And with the help of anonymous objects, we are calling the method. We can create normal objects with the help of normal objects also. We can call the method. Run, I'm calling here. So wherever the main method is there, with that class name only, we have to save the file name. That's why I have saved as final inheritance.java. Now it is extends Honda2, where in Honda2 we have a method called as run. And when the child is extending the parent, automatically whatever the variables, whatever the data members, whatever the methods, whatever the subclasses are there in the parent class, it will automatically acquire by this chain class. So with the help of that, I'm just calling run method. But in a final inheritance, there is no run method, but it is extending, it is inheriting the properties of parent. That's why it is called the run method of this, displaying the output as run. Let me see, run the program. Java C space final inheritance dot Java. It is running, right? No errors. Now run the program. Java space, see the output. Run. Okay, so this is how we can make sure, we can make sure of that way method can be inherited, but a class can't be inherited. Just remember that when a variable has declared as a final, then that variable is called as constant. When a method has declared as final, we can avoid method overwriting. When a class has declared as final, we can make prevent inheritance. When a method, with the help of a method, if you want to be inherited a method, a class can't be inherited once the class has declared as final, but a method can be inherited with the help of final, with the help of that inheritance concept. So that's about the final keyword in Java. Okay.